You may think you already know enough Windows shortcuts, like the usual Alt-Tab or Control-C, Control-V. Today's not about that. Instead, I'm going to cover some amazing Windows shortcuts you probably didn't know existed and you wished you knew earlier. But yeah, better late than never. First shortcut is Windows D. This is one I pretty much use daily. When you select it, it brings up the desktop. Press it again and it hides the desktop and you go back to where you were. A related shortcut is Windows comma. Notice what happens. You get a peek at the desktop. Now, as long as you're holding down the Windows key, the desktop is going to be shown. This is great for when someone walks in on you and you don't want them to see what you're working on. Once you let go of the Windows key, it switches back to your application. This is probably my son's most used shortcut. Next up is Windows V. This one is a standard shortcut that everyone should use, no exceptions. It brings up the clipboard history. From here, you can paste your previously copied items. You can quickly navigate with the arrow keys, find what you want to paste, and then just press enter. You see, the great bit is that you're not restricted to your last copied items like you are when you do Control-C, Control-V. Instead, with Windows V, you see your last copied items, but you also see all the items before that. You can copy up to 25 items and then paste them one after another in your document. You can also pin frequently used items, like a standard response. Just click on this pin icon to pin it. Pinning an item keeps it from being removed from the clipboard history even after you reboot your computer. Next one is Windows period. This brings up the emoji picker so you can quickly add some color to your text. You can use the arrow keys to browse or search for something specific using the search box. If you'd rather add a GIF, just go down and select a GIF of your choice. Next up is Windows Plus. This brings up the Windows magnifier and you get to zoom in as much as you want to wherever your mouse is on the screen. So the more I press Windows Plus, the more I zoom in. To zoom out, use Windows Minus. Now this is great for when you're presenting files like Microsoft Excel and you want to zoom into the formula bar. Bring your mouse beside the formula bar and use Windows Plus. To zoom out, Windows Minus. Under Settings, you can define your default zoom level as well as the zoom increment. To turn off the magnifier, use Windows Escape. Next one is Control K. When you're in an internet browser, you don't need to go with your mouse into the search box and then type in the address that you want. Simply press Control K and then start typing. This works in most browsers. Next up is Control Shift T. So while we're in the topic of browsers, if you happen to close a tab by accident, so let's say I close these, you can easily bring them back using the shortcut key Control-Shift-T, and this is going to bring them back in the same order that you close them. Windows Tab is next. This opens up Task View, which displays all of your open apps as tiles so that you can choose which one you want to focus on. Just simply navigate using the arrow keys, press Enter to jump to that specific app. You can use Tab to jump to the bottom bit that displays your virtual desktops. Simply navigate using the arrow keys, press Enter to jump to that virtual desktop. Next up is Windows L. If you work in an office with others, it's usually a good idea to lock your screen when you leave your desk. Otherwise, all kinds of bad things can happen. To do that, use the shortcut Windows L. This keeps your apps open but locks your screen. Then simply unlock your PC before using them again. Last up is Windows X. If you want to shut down your computer completely, use the shortcut Windows X, followed by U and then another U to shut it down. But I don't recommend shutting down your system like that. If you want to have a clean start next time you turn on your computer, consider disabling Fast Startup in your Power Options settings. I have a separate video explaining this. Check it out. Link to it is in the cards. Okay, that's it. These are my favorite Windows shortcuts. Let me know if you have a favorite or if you have any other shortcuts you use a lot. I'd love to know. That's it for now. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you aren't subscribed yet, and I'm going to catch you in the next video.